Welcome back in LADALIDI's tutorial. In today's video I'm gonna show you how to create this editable neon text effect part 3 with 3D base. In the previous two tutorials, I've shown you how to create an editable neon text effect. The first tutorial uses only fills, and the second one uses only strokes, and finally for this third part, I'll show you how to combine fills and strokes, and add a 3D effect to get an editable neon text effect with a new style. We start by creating a background with a purple galaxy with scattered stars. Then create a 3D text effect. After that we create a neon effect in it and make the 3D text that was earlier to be a frame for the neon in it. So don't skip this video and watch till the end. By the way, you can download the file project in the description with the color palette that I use in this tutorial. So without any further ado, let's jump into Adobe Illustrator. Create a document with size 1920 by 1080 pixels. And don't forget to use RGB color mode. Otherwise you will not get the same result as what I made in this tutorial if you use CMYK color mode. Before we start creating this editable neon text, I want to input all the colors into the swatches to make it easier for us to create this editable text. In addition, you can download this color palette in the description. For this tutorial, I will not explain in detail for each of the steps that I do because I have explained them in detail in the previous two tutorials. For this tutorial I will be quick to shorten the time. Okay, let's start by adding these four flat colors first. Select these four flat colors, then open the swatches panel. In the swatches panel, click new color group and name it whatever you want. Then for these three gradient colors we will add them to the swatches one by one. Select the first gradient, then click new swatch in the swatches panel. You can also give it a name, but I just clicked OK without giving it a name. Do the same step with the other two gradients. Now, we have four flat colors and three gradient colors in the swatches. Now we move on to creating this editable text. First, we're going to create a purple galaxy background with the stars like this. A bit more like creating a Star Wars background but with a purple color. Create a rectangle with the same size as the artboard using the rectangle tool. Give it the third gradient from the three gradient colors that we added to the swatches earlier. After that use the gradient tool in the toolbar to adjust it a bit. Drag in this little black circle inside the artboard to make this gradient flattened. After that, drag out this little black square out of the artboard to make the radius of this gradient bigger. In that way we get a gradient color with a smooth transition and evenly spread inside the rectangle. Next, we are going to add a texture of stars to this background. Create another rectangle using the rectangle tool, and just give it a flat black color. To give it a texture, go to the Effect menu. Sketch. Reticulation. In this reticulation panel, change the density to 10. Leave the rest at 0. Click OK. After that, open the transparency panel, and change the blending mode from normal to color dodge. And lower the opacity down to 70%. And it's done perfectly. Now we just have to lock this layer, and create a new layer to put the editable neon text. Create the text using the text tool on the toolbar. Make the text size 480 points. For the font, use the boldest font. And in this tutorial, I'm using the Gil Sans Ultra Bold font. You can use other fonts but remember to use the boldest font. Open the character panel from here. And set tracking to 100. Place it in the center of the artboard using vertical and horizontal align center. Now open the appearance panel. In the previous tutorial I explained about the appearance panel in detail. You can watch it if there is something you don't understand about the appearance panel in this tutorial. Double click the character's layer. And set the fill color to none to make it transparent. Click the top layer to return to the default appearance. In the next part, we will add effects to create a 3D text neon effect. First, click Add New Fill at the bottom of the panel to add a new fill layer to this text. Click the drop-down menu in the color box to open the swatches panel, and choose the first gradient color that we inputted earlier. After that, open the gradient panel, and change the gradient angle to 90 degrees. Just like that, go back to the appearance panel to add some effects to this layer. While this fill layer is still selected, just click Add New Effect, Stylize, Round Corners, and give it a radius of 3 pixels. You can skip this step if you use a bold font that already has round corners. Again, click Add New Effect. Stylize and Inner Glow. Multiplier mode, and change the color to dark purple color. Just double-click on this color box. Select purple on the color slider, and adjust the color in the color field until you find a dark purple color. Click OK. Set its opacity to 50%. Blur 20 pixels, and click OK when finished. After adding an inner glow to this layer, add another drop shadow. Add new effect. Stylize, and drop shadow. For the blending mode, select multiply. Opacity 75%, X and Y offset, 0 pixels. And for blur set to 2 pixels. Click OK, and we're done adding effects to this layer. Next, create a new fill layer. Select this fill layer first, then click Add New Fill at the bottom of this appearance panel. For this new fill layer, it will be different from the previous one, and different from the layer fill that I have made in previous videos, because I will not be using a flat color or gradient, but I will give it a pattern. Because the pattern that will be used for this fill layer is not in the swatches panel by default, or does not exist, so we have to create it first. We will only create a simple horizontal line pattern. You can create a different and better pattern than the one I made here. Create a long rectangle using the rectangle tool. Activate the rectangle tool on the toolbar, and click anywhere on the artboard. Fill the width with 700 pixels, and height by 4 pixels. Click OK. To create a pattern with this rectangle, we just need to go to the object menu, pattern, and make. Just click OK if you find this warning window. This warning just tells us that the pattern we created from this long rectangle has been added to the swatches. And the important thing to note, is this pattern options panel, because here we will modify the pattern that has been added to the swatches. In this panel you can give it a name, and I just named it, pattern, because I don't think it really matters. Next, change the width to 700 pixels. And height to 9 pixels. Then click the drop-down menu on copies, and select 9x9. When finished, click Done on the pattern bar above here. Now just delete this rectangle because our pattern is already in the swatches panel over here. Reselect this text and reopen the appearance panel. Click this second fill layer, and click this drop down button to open the swatches panel. And just select the pattern that we just created. Now, we just need to blend it with the gradient color layer below. Click this opacity to open the transparency panel. Change the blending mode to multiply. And lower the opacity down to 20%. And just like that. Now we are going to add a 3D effect to this text by adding a new layer below this gradient fill layer. First, click on this character's layer to place the new layer that we will create on top of it. Click Add New Fill. Change the color to the second gradient color. After that, open the gradient panel to change the gradient angle to 90 degrees. Back again to the appearance panel. Add new effect. Path. Offset path. Fill the offset with 16 pixels, and just click OK. By adding an offset path, we will get a frame effect outside of this line pattern. Add new effect again. Stylize. Round corners. Fill the radius with 10 pixels. Click OK. Now we have got this character with round corner in each corner. Next, we will add more effects to get a realistic feel. Add new effect. Stylize. Inner glow. On the inner glow panel, change the blending mode to overlay. Make sure the glow color is white. To change it, you just double-click on this color box, and just select white color in this color field. Click OK when finished. Next, opacity to 75%. Blur 5 pixels. And click OK. Here you can see the body of this text is like getting a reflection of light from the stars behind it. Then we just give it a three-dimensional effect, but not a real three-dimension. Here we just add an effect to give it a 3D impression. Still on this third fill layer, and add a new effect. Distort and transform. Transform. In the transform effect panel, change the horizontal and vertical scale to 99%. Horizontal and vertical moves 0.1 pixels. And for copies, fill with 15. Click OK. And here we have made this text look like 3D object. The next step is that we are going to add a neon in the middle of this 3D text. So it will appear that this neon is attached to the floating 3D text body. So let's get started. We start by giving this existing topmost stroke layer with white. Click the drop-down menu to open the swatches panel and select white. After that, fill the stroke with 4 points. Then add new effect. Path. Offset path. Fill it with minus 40 pixels for offset. Joins in miter. Miter limit with 4. Click OK. Once we've got the right size for this neon, now, we're going to make the corners round. Add new effect. Stylize. Round corners. And fill the radius with 10 pixels. Click OK. Actually, we made this first stroke, and I named it the main stroke, and this main stroke becomes the basic shape for the neon that we are going to create. With this main stroke we get a text that is slimmer and smaller than the original shape. Besides that, we also get round corners in every corner. Now, we're going to give it some color by adding a few more stroke layers, and we're going to add a stroke between the fill layer and the stroke layer. But this time we don't need to create a new stroke layer with the new stroke button below. All we need to do is just duplicate the stroke, which has existed. Why do I prefer to duplicate it? Because in this existing stroke there are two effects, which are the offset path effect, and the round corners effect, and with these two effects we get the neon shape that we see now. But if we create a new stroke with this new stroke button, then we will get a stroke from scratch, which means, we have to add these two effects again to the new stroke, while to create a neon effect we need a few more stroke layers, so to save time we just need to duplicate this existing stroke with the two effects contained in it. First, select this main stroke layer. Then click on Duplicate Selected Item, which is at the bottom of this appearance panel. Now, we have got two strokes. Select the second stroke layer because it is this stroke that we will modify. First, change the color by clicking on this drop-down menu. Then choose the lightest pink color from the color group that we created at the beginning of the video. After that, increase the stroke to 8 points. Once again, we don't need to add any more effects, just these two effects. Next, duplicate this layer again by clicking the duplicate button at the bottom of the panel. Change its color to a pink, and increase the stroke to 12 pixels. Now we've got this neon color, which is pink. Once we have got this neon color, now we're going to give it ambient light around this neon by adding a glow effect. Click the Add New Effect button. Stylize. Outer Glow. In the Outer Glow panel, double-click this color box to change its color. Choose the same pink color as the pink on this stroke. You can get it by moving this color slider until it reaches the hue position in pink. Then in the color field, click and drag to this position. Click OK if you get the right pink color. Set the blend mode to screen. Opacity 75%, and a 6-pixel blur. Click OK. Next, we're going to make this neon more luminous. Duplicate this last layer again. Select the bottom stroke layer. Reveal the effect layer if you find it closed, just click this mark to reveal it. Then select the outer glow effect, and delete it. We don't need this glow effect on this new stroke layer, because we're going to give this stroke a blur effect. Add new effect. Blur. Gaussian blur. Fill the radius with 14 pixels. And click OK. Duplicate this layer again. And lower the Gaussian blur radius to 3 pixels. And what's happening here is, we've created two stroke layers with a Gaussian blur effect, the first with a radius of 14 pixels and the last one with a radius of 3 pixels. In this way, we got a neon result that is brighter and looks like it's actually lit. And the last step is, we will do on this neon is to give it a shadow effect so that we will get the impression that this neon has a distance from the 3D body text behind it. Duplicate again this bottom stroke layer, which is just above the top fill layer. Change the color of this stroke to solid black. And lower the stroke weight to 8 points. Add a transform effect by clicking Add New Effect. Distort and transform. Transform. Fill the horizontal and vertical moves with 10 pixels. Leave everything else by default and click OK. Now, we have finished this editable 3D neon text effect. You just have to double-click on this text to edit it, type any text you like. That's all for this tutorial. You can download the project file at the link I have prepared in the description. If this Adobe Illustrator tutorial is useful, don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification bell. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. See you in the next Adobe Illustrator tutorial.